with Judas Priest, Glenn Tipton and Rob Halford.
Hello, Jackie. Nice Hello. To see you again. Here we are. Can you believe the sunshine? See, we do get sunshine in England occasionally.
Well, you're only going to get tan on your back, aren't you?
Yes, yeah. Roasting in leather, but still. Getting nice and hot for tonight's show.
Oh, so you're currently on tour to promote your 13th album, aren't you? Ram It Down. Do you think it's the heaviest album you've done? Glenn?
Yes, I think it's the heaviest album we've done. No, I think it's more representative of Judas Priest than, say, Turbo. You know, Turbo was probably the most talked about album we've ever done. But no, Ram It Down is definitely more in the Priest. You know, where people expect us to come from. So. Mm. We didn't go in there really consciously trying to write an ultra heavy album, but I think subconsciously, you know, we went in there and needed to prove a point. So we're really pleased with it.
Good. Rob, how do you feel about it now you've distanced yourself away from the studio?
Yes.
I mean, you listen to it now. I mean, when you're in the studio, you've got it run down your throat, literally.
You do.
Every day.
It's difficult to actually... it is... I mean, when you put distance away from it, you can look at it in a slightly more objective way. I think you tend to look at it more as a... Hopefully, as a fan would look at it, you know, because when you're listening to it in such a refined state, you're listening for the hi-hat and the EQ. And everything else, and you're trying to get off on it, but you're so into making the thing sound good that you do get so immersed. So when you come away from it after a few weeks, then you can really just start to enjoy it for the pleasure and just get off on the music, you know.
So I'm
enjoying it now more than I probably was in the studio in that respect. Mm, yeah.
So you're not disappointed when you heard it on your car stereo or whatever?
Well, actually, we go through a process of, when we're in the studio, of listening to it in various different ways, not just through the big mammoth studio speakers. We listen to it in different rooms and different environments to make sure it works everywhere. But certainly when you're away, if you're going down the M1, you put Ram It Down on, and suddenly you're doing 90 instead of 70, that's when it's doing the job, you know what I mean?
So we actually do put it down on cassette sometimes and go and listen to it in a car as we drive along. Certain tracks, you know, you can see the power of them more, or whether you can, you know, if you listen clinically in a room to something, then you do pick up on the finer points. If you just listen in sort of a casual environment, you just know if the track sounds overall right, and you don't get too picky with it. Mm.
Tom Allen produced the album again, didn't he? You work with Stock Aitken and Waterman for a wee while?
To
what
who?
Happened to that?
Who?
Those people. Come on,
what?
All right, let's get the record straight. Yes, we did work with Stock, Aitken and Waterman, and we don't like them because they're not very good table tennis players. No. Good friends of ours, they're old friends of ours, Peter, a Coventry lad, and we went in, we did 4 days in Paris, we got 4 days in between Christmas and going back into the studio. And it was a mutual thing, an experiment to just see what would come of it, you know. We weren't chasing hit singles, we'd actually finished our album anyway, and we've only got mixes left to do.
They were obviously useless then, so you changed your producer.
No,
anyway,
no, in actual fact, they were real good, and I think what people don't realise about them is that there's far more to them than hit producers. I mean, Mike Stock's a great guitar player, you know, and we work really well together. The tracks we came up with were very interesting. I don't suppose they'll ever be on a Judas Priest album, but we've been approached a lot recently to do film soundtracks and things, so maybe it'll be used for that. Who knows?
That's great.
But no, we were really pleased with the outcome, and we've never been scared to experiment. So,
well, I think people thought, you know, it was bizarre because we were surprised at the sudden, almost like a backlash. People thought it was going to be like Judas Banana Armour Priest or something. God forbid we should ever do that. We've got, you know, we wouldn't compromise the band on anything of that nature. But as it's turned out, like Glenn says, we've got a fantastic heavy ballad and we've got two real good rock tracks.
Right.
But we've got too much material for Ram It Down and
anyway,
so
we thought they
came.
Got too much money. We didn't want to earn any more, so we decided to just shelve it.
Anyway, let's take a look at the track of one of your older albums, British Steel. It's called After Midnight. Glenn, Judas Priest have been lying low for the last 4.5 years or so. How do you think your status is now as far as the British rock and roll public's concerned?
Well, we'll know very shortly as we've just embarked upon the new British tour, and we have been away a long time. We've had a lot of commitments. Well, it wasn't a conscious effort to do so. And I think the public are going to welcome us back, you know. I mean, we've done two shows, one in Birmingham, our hometown, on Sunday, and last night was Hammersmith, and tonight's Hammersmith. And the audience response has been overwhelming, you know. It's really made us feel good to be back, and we shouldn't have stayed away so long, but we're back now, and I don't think we'll be staying away so long again.
That's great. Rob, Glenn just mentioned the audience reaction. Are you really excited about it? Are they going hell for leather for you?
Absolutely, yeah. I mean, we never lose fact that we're a British heavy metal band, and this is our home, you know, so it's a great thrill to come back, and at the Birmingham show it was like, you know, Kleenex time type thing.
Oh.
No, it was great, it was fantastic, and what we've noticed over these first two shows is the you know, just the intense reaction. It's been wonderful. I mean, as it has been a few years since we came back, it seems as though the metal maniacs are even more enthusiastic than ever before. So that's fantastic for us, you know. They go crazy, we go even, you know, more crazy on stage.
Oh, and your gig in Birmingham, your hometown, is actually in a small venue as well, so that must have been really sort of cozy.
Yeah, I mean, that's what we've been saying just recently. We feel that to an extent metal's got a little bit out of control with all the monsters and all that kind of stuff, you know, and we want to try and get back to the basics, which is always what we've said, the music comes first. So that small show we played in Birmingham was proof of that this band delivers regardless of where you put us, you know, and we just want to re-emphasise that fact. So that's what you're seeing. You're seeing Priest in the raw, in the flesh on this tour.
Right. Well, let's take a look at another track off Pretty Steel. It's called Breaking the Law. Rob, why did it
win? Looking at Centre Point. No. Is it still empty?
I don't know.
People are in there. That was a controversial building when it was built, by the way.
Anyway, back to business. Why, yes, do you think most of the fans come and see you these days? Is it for the stage show or actually because they know and love all your music?
I think we've got a, you know, Priest is a bit of an institution in the heavy metal world. I mean, we're probably one of the longest surviving heavy metal acts. And so there's a lot of interest. They make you feel old then. Yeah. There's a lot of interest about the band. And I think that we still deliver. We still put on a damn good show. And I think that apart from the fact that we've got a fantastic loyal following, not only in Britain but the rest of Europe, that that support and that loyalty is something that we always appreciate tremendously. So it's a combination of all those different elements together. And beyond that, new people, you know, we're already seeing new faces in the crowd that have never seen the Priest before. So, you know, we're bringing more people into the Priest environment, and it's just an ongoing thing that never seems to grow. It's like the monster of rock out of control, you know.
So you've got old and new fans all coming.
Absolutely,
together.
Yeah, it's wonderful.
Maybe some that have only heard like your latest album.
Probably so, but as you know, this Ram It Down's our 13th album, so if you want to find out a bit more about the Priest, there's plenty more of us available on vinyl or tape or whatever.
I don't know, doing your own promotion.
It was a good plug, wasn't it?
How about the Harley Davidson bike? You're still using that on stage?
Yeah, we still bring the bike out. That's part and parcel of, you know, something that Priest has had over the years, and that's what people want to see. So, you know, we're not going to deny them the bike. And it works great with Hellbent for Leather, which is basically a motorbiking song. So we've still got the bike with us. And
it's just bad news if Rob's in one of his wilder moods and you happen to be in the front two rows.
Keep taking the keys off me, you know.
Goes off the edge.
Wild dude, call me Marlon, you know what I mean?
So are there any other gimmicks on stage, Glenn?
Very few this time, Jackie. We've got back to the roots of heavy metal. We're fortunate that we've got 13 albums to draw from, you know, in terms of material. And we've got a lot of Priest classics that we can play, and we just set out this time to just do two things, to play heavy metal and to try and simplify it. We've got a fantastic light show, all credit to Louis Ball, our lighting technician. He'll like me for saying that. It's a very good show, light show, and that's all we're taking out. There's no gimmicks, just heavy metal.
Well, talking of bikes, we've got a track coming up now called Free Wheel. Glenn, what material are you using on this tour? Is it all up your old albums or old and new?
We've actually, it's old and new. We're doing a lot of stuff off Ram It Down, and we're bringing back a lot of old favourites. You know, people keep asking us to do Beyond the Realms of Death or The Ripper or The Sinner, Victim of Changes. So we've brought back a lot of the older stuff, and we're playing a lot of the new stuff. The last tour is the Turbo Tour, so we're not concentrating that this time so much, but we've had so many requests for the old favourites that we dropped, you know, some of them, and we just felt it was time to bring them back. So this is an old and new tour.
Are you playing every track off Ram It Down?
We play five, I think. Four or five.
Five of them.
You know, with a current album, if it hasn't been out too long, I think the kids only want to hear about four or five, because otherwise, you know, they're still not quite that familiar with it. We can only physically play for 2 hours because we put so much energy in there. So we have to miss certain things out. We have to try and give everybody a cross-section. You're always going to disappoint some people, but we try and please as many as we can.
Only 2 hours. What about the venues, Rob? Are they bigger than usual, smaller, or...?
Well, I'm pleased to say that for the most part, Priest play pretty large venues, you know, and as far as the UK is concerned, we'd very much at some point now we're establishing ourselves yet again in Great Britain to come back and do, you know, maybe an NEC in the Midlands or a Wembley. But I mean, this band started doing the clubs and the pubs way back, and it's just again re-emphasising this business of the music being the most important factor. So, as I said to you before, I think Jackie, you know, he's a 13-amp fuse socket in the wall, just bung it in and we'll give you some metal, it doesn't really matter. We have to have certain facilities available to us, of course. I mean, but for the most part, you'll find Priest in a multitude of different situations.
Oh, I bet.
Absolutely.
So how do you stay fit for all this? Don't give me any crew dancers either.
Well, that's another point.
Crew dancers? We wouldn't give crew dancers on the television.
We're very nice people. I mean, the fact is that we've had such tremendous luck to be around for as long as we have, that we do put a great deal of work and professionalism into our performances, so we stay in good shape. I mean, you don't want to go in there with a hangover after the night before, so we pace ourselves as far as that's concerned, and we go out and give 100%, so we stay clean for the most part.
Right.
And then when we're not working, we do all the, you know, the other stuff.
Well, listen, have a brilliant time on the rest of the tour. Where is it you're up next after London?
We're off after Hammersmith. We're off up to Leicester and Newcastle and Edinburgh and Newport and Manchester. So come and see us. It'll be great.
Great. What can I say? Anyway, we'll finish today with a track off Ram It Down, and it is of course Johnny B. Goode. Say goodbye.
Bye-bye.